I guess so. In this video, I want to touch bases on how to export your project into Google Earth. So what do you need? You need an active project, and one important thing for the export is that you have either the calibration or you know the projection of your job and it's added. How to check that? You're gonna go to your project explorer and you should have a job site with the coordinate system, published coordinate system. Once you have that, it's very easy. You select the entities you want to export to Google Earth. You're gonna go home and there is a Google Earth icon. You're gonna click on that. Google offset north and easting, it's zero for this because I have a calibration. I'm exporting 1054 entities and I want to clamp it to ground, or you can have it absolute. Once you hit apply, the computer will open automatically Google Earth and fly into your project area, and it will place the line work directly on the ground. I'm just gonna rotate it nicely flat, rotate it to the north, and you can kind of walk through your job site now and see how it's gonna look. The next question is, how do you take the Google Earth image and bring it back to Business Center? So now you can put in title block, do a beautiful picture for printing, for presentations, or whatever you need to. So the way I usually do it is, I'm gonna turn on some points which I have on my site, and I like this, let's say this point and this point, which are my property pins. I'm gonna export those into Google Earth through the Google Earth icon and hit apply. This will open my Google Earth, again fly me into the location of my project. Once I'm there, I'm gonna rotate it nicely flat, point to the north so it's nice and easy. I'm gonna zoom out a little bit, make sure I'm nice and flat, right? But the next step I'm gonna turn off the point name. So basically, I'm gonna rename this and just put it zero, and rename this and put no name. So all I have left on my map is the two squares. So I'm gonna say, okay, this looks good. Now, do I want the road? I can turn off the road and all that jazz, which is pretty cool right now. So all I have is these two little squares. Look at the properties of this point, right? Can even make it a little bit smaller here. So it's really small, so it's not that big. So when you bring it back to the Business Center, it's not gonna really interfere with the whole project. Like it that it's green, because I have a green, some forest there, so it's not that bad. The next step I wanna do is, I wanna save image. I'm gonna hit my options and turn everything off. That's why you wanna zoom out a little bit, right? So in case there is something around, then you don't have to cut it. You can always cut it off. I'm gonna go to the maximum available resolution, and then I'm gonna hit save image. I'm gonna save it on my desktop and call it Google background. Hit save. Again, now depending on your internet speed, this may take, you know, a minute or two or three, whatever it takes. So at this point, I should have my Google background on my desktop. So I'm gonna open back my project and I'm just gonna drag and drop the saved image. When you bring an image to the Business Center, the first comment which is automatically open is place image. However, we wanna georeference image. So then I'm going to grab a point and I'm going to zoom in to my point. You see how I made it smaller? It's still quite big. I'm going to center myself, and this point goes to my corner pin. Then I'm going to add another one, which is this property corner somewhere here. Oh, there it is. Beautiful. Which is another property corner, and I'm going to georeference it to the point which I have shot in a field and export it to the Google. So it snapped it in, and right now I have a nice Google Earth image as my background on my project. So in case you had like let's say you don't want to see this Trimble logo, I usually have like a clipping boundary. I can take it and undertake all. Yeah, I can apply that boundary to my Google background. This will cut off the image, and I'm ready to work with this as my project going forward. Hope you found this video interesting. Don't forget to hit like, comment, and we'll see you next time. Bye.